Requires a barbell for step. This doesn't have any plates on it yet, but you're going to want to have a grip that's wide enough that you're not going to hit your legs with your hands. I go even wider than some people do. And then it just starts with a deadlift. You're going to deadlift it up, and then from here it's going to be a hip extension shrug. Now if you've done that correctly, the bar should be weightless or even floating up a little bit, right? At which time you're going to pull yourself down. So I'll do the whole thing at speed. Catch it in a front squat. Now it's important for you to get your elbows up. I don't want to be holding it out here like this. So elbows high, stand it up, that would be one full rep.
That this thing spins.
Oh yeah, yeah, yeah.
And that you actually turn under the bar and not the bar turning around you, right?
Yeah, you don't, I mean, if this didn't spin, you would have to reverse curl it or something like that, but the Olympic lifting bars, yeah, they spin. So your hands are gonna essentially change position and you can get those elbows high without having to curl it or bring it up to your chest.
Can you show me, point it out to me when Zach does it in slow motion right now?
Point out exactly what?
Someone, what point it is that the person pulls themselves under.
Yeah, Zach, come here. People are trying to control the object. You gotta control where your body positions are. Don't control the object. If your body positions are in the right place, the object will be where it's supposed to be.
I like that.
Yeah, you sound smart.
Zach,
come
here a second.
So start his deadlift. He's gonna move his knees out of the way as his chest comes up to have a straight path of the bar. Hip extension right there. The bar's weightless. He's not gonna try to pull it up higher. He's gonna use it to pull himself down, and the bar will spin that allows him to do that nice slow motion with the empty bar. And then he's gonna catch it, like I said, on his shoulders, not in his hands, out in front of him, and then drive his legs, power through his torso into the bar to stand it up.
And we can tell he did it properly. Also, a visual cue is that the bar traveled in a perfect straight line, right?
Yeah, we want the bar path to be as straight as possible. And like I said, don't try to control the bar, control the positions of your body to get that to happen.